Good morning, folks. I hope you are doing well. It's quite a while since my last video. Actually, I was very busy in some industry events and writing something for the standard bodies. Hopefully, I will regularly share some key findings over the next couple of weeks. Today, I am here to share with you about Edge and what as the telecom engineers or the telecom architects, you should be crazy to hear about it, right? Edge is something which the public cloud providers like Azure, like AWS, Outpost, Wavelength, and Google, Anthos, it's quite famous and with a ready product. So why really about the telecom? So it's very important to understand what has recently happened, especially with the ushering of 5G, which made Edge a real use case for telcos, and somehow the hyperscalers also intend to join the same bandwagon with the telcos, lead by the telcos. So about the Edge use cases, we see that most of the very innovative use cases of Edge, which we initially thought may be mature, maybe somewhere around 2022-2023, somehow with the recent advantages on the connectivity options like 5G and with the software architecture like Kubernetes and the nimble version of Kubernetes, K3S, and with new sidecar and the ingress controllers and the network service mesh, all those features, it has made sense that the Edge market is maturing earlier than expected. We believe most of the Edge use cases will come to fruition in the next 12 to 24 months, and time to act is now. The reason is very simple. If telcos leave this opportunity, so same thing will happen what happened in the OTT era in 3G, and the hyperscalers will cannibalize the market. By the way, they have already started to do so. Luckily, there are some key initiatives where they have been collaborating with the service providers. And but somehow this is still a risk because they have a global reach and a good reputation when it comes to the applications itself. For telco, we first need to see if we bundle the Edge introduction with 5G. It will make certain sense from investment as well as from the use case point of view. The latest 3GPP release 16, especially with the use cases like the building of the connectivity, private 5G, which we also call the campus networks, the use of the new features, for example, the 5G LAN, where you can integrate all the 5G devices in a campus without going to the core itself, right, or using a layer 2 VPN type of context. Then the advanced or ultra latency use cases like the time sensitive networks, and the maturity around the end-to-end slicing. This has really made it possible to realize the Edge. Because I often used to say this word, right? When we talk about distributed clouds, building a million of clusters, but we don't know how to really connect them with the SLA and experience, then it makes no sense. I think this is very important thing for telcos to focus on. Then when it comes to connectivity, it's very important that Edge is a solution that should be able to host in any cloud provider, in any form factor. For example, public cloud, private cloud, on-prem, Kubernetes. And it's very important also to see the connectivity options in terms of verticals. What the oil and gas industry is using today, what hospitals are using today, whether SD-WAN or clubbing of other FTTH solutions with 5G and Wi-Fi 6 makes sense. These all are very important for a telecom point of view. Then most importantly, you need to see that 5G is a high-speed pipe, but Edge is a constraint. So somehow you need to see how one can offset the disadvantages of others. we really need to see that the vision of the scaled down version of 5G standalone core is very important. For example, if we want to deploy UPF in 2U server, if you need to bring lot of applications using the same SDKs with the 5G core, this is very important aspect to address, and you really need to see it from the eyes of the cloud and software. Then it comes to the business model. It's very important after the solution is mature, how to really sell it to the software developers, how to reach them. Our prime target is SaaS, but obviously we think in the current phase we have to start through IaaS and the PaaS models. And the attraction of developer is very, very important. And also, you know, we need to see if we need to build a global framework across the geographical boundaries. So who will offer the service? Who will use it? How to invoice it? These all are very, very important and sensitive matters. Then the most important is what we will offer to developer. In this region, we specifically feel developer need a simple ways to onboard the application, but a complete tool set for the testing. The reality is that a developer do not expect, say, 100 open source tools who they have to spend time to troubleshoot and fix, but to have a end-to-end solution, maybe 10 software tools and SDK, fully functional, maybe Python, Ruby, Rails, Selenium, or JDK environments, maybe a couple of others. That's very important for the early success of this market. And finally, the end-to-end SLA is very important to use the advantages from the slicing and other initiative to give them a clear SLA. It's very important to see the operation, automation, and analytics. In terms of use cases in the Middle East, we clearly see that the coverage of the live events and the smart hajj and the religious events, then the retail, FMCG, oil, gas, especially the video surveillance and remote control, then the public safety and consumers. These are the clear hit areas for the edge, and we really need to build a global framework along the four dimensions of the 3GPP or traditional telco standards, followed by connectivity, business model, and operations. Next, let us talk about the use case of cloud native. As I told you that 5G is a high-speed pipe, but edge is a constrained environment. So today, how the vision of the software architecture is supporting? I just try to sum up this to make sure that your infrastructure and the software visions are aligned together. As we can see today, what is an edge? Edge is a constrained environment, right? So reduced control. Reduced control means it can power off and on, it can become faulty, fire, all those, because it's not a tier 1 or tier 3 data centers at the end of the day. Maybe something very non-standard in certain cases. So the use of the software architectures like cloud native to deploy an immutable infrastructure is definitely helping us out to treat everything as a cattle. Restricted resources, as I said, that edge is something, is not a cattle ranch, and we should be able to speed it up in whatever options available. Then it comes the limited connectivity options. In terms of bandwidth, imagine a site with the traditional, let's say, a microwave or a very nimble, maybe 10 MB connection. So how to deliver an application in that constrained environment? Definitely resilient and declarative API is the answer. Because whenever bandwidth is low and once it's restored, the system will return to a desired state through the provisioning or through the orchestration solution like Ansible and Terraform. I think this is definitely we need to see value into it. Something that will really convert whole your infrastructure as a code. In terms of risky locations, again, this is very important that we are able to observe the sites in real time and manage it in real time. Obviously, machine learning and AI at the edge is no longer a requirement, it's a necessity.
and the observations is very, very important in the real time. Luckily, the Kubernetes have a number of telemetry and open telemetry, open data platform type of solutions which are helping us out. Delay and disconnections, again, this is very important to apply a robotic end-to-end automation. For example, imagine in the legacy telecom world, when the site is down and the connection comes back, there is a set of commands that you need to set up to check the connection, then to restore the link, and then you put all the traffic on this. This is changing with the edge because you need to have an automated way to not only establish the layer 2 or layer 1 connectivity once it is back, but to handshake and establish the application connection on the fly. This is something we have experienced in the SD-WAN, and it has really delivered the results. Now is the time to expand it across a wider applications, including both 5G standalone or cloud native applications and the edge itself. So this is very, very important that we focus and address on these dimensions. That is why I strongly emphasize telco engineers see edge as a reinvention of internet and see it from a production or a software point of view. So this is all about for today, and I will be coming with a new episode shortly. Thanks for hanging with me and listening to me. Thank